of my underlying principles is that your diet has to be nutrient-rich. In addition to that, we have to have the full complement of nutrients the human body needs to maximize its health. Now, I use the term G-bombs to represent the salient features in certain foods that have powerful phytochemicals that fight cancer. And the same phytonutrients that fight cancer also inhibit fat storage on the body. And the same phytonutrients that fight cancer and inhibit fat storage in the body improve immune function, protect against autoimmune disease, and protect against infection. So it's very important that these nutrients are needed. They're very important that these nutrients are present to have an optimal functioning immune system. And the G-bombs stand for the term, obviously G-bomb stands for G-B-O-M-B-S. G for greens, B for beans, O for onions, M for mushrooms, B for berries, S for seeds. Greens, beans, onions, mushrooms, berries, and seeds. And we can talk about each of those foods individually, but they each have powerful phytochemicals that have dramatic effects in protecting us against cancer. And I make the statement all the time that, can you imagine if our population ate a big salad every day with mushrooms and beans in it, with some cruciferous raw vegetables like watercress, arugula, or shredded cabbage? What if our whole population had a big salad every day? What if they had flax seeds or chia seeds in their breakfast oatmeal? What if they had berries every day? What if they had mushrooms every day? What if they ate all these foods on a regular basis, flooding their body with the phytochemicals humans need to support optimal health? We would see cancer rates radically disappear. We'd see cancer rates drop right now from our population having, ravaged with cancer to a population where cancer is relatively a rare occurrence, where, like it was, many, many generations ago. So the point that I'm making is that the diseases that plague Americans, which is predominantly heart attacks, strokes, and cancer, those are predominantly what kill Americans, that those are avoidable. They're preventable and avoidable through nutritional excellence. And nutritional science has made dramatic advancements in recent years. And if we apply these advancements and give people that opportunity to utilize modern nutritional science, they have a unique opportunity in human history to protect themselves against these diseases. And we can wipe out heart disease and wipe out strokes and wipe out most cancers. And we can live longer with better healthy life expectancy, with a better quality of life than ever before in human history. The problem is nobody's taking advantage of these recent advances in nutritional science. And my, obviously, mission is to make this better known so that people can have the opportunity to take advantage of this information. Well, I see this, that we have an unprecedented opportunity in human history right now because nutritional science has made such incredible advances in the recent years, in the last 10 or 15 years. We know that we have enough information now to give people the opportunity not to have a heart attack, not to have a stroke. If you want that, never to have a heart attack or a stroke, you can have that. If you want not to get breast cancer, not to get prostate cancer, not to get colon cancer, you can have that opportunity. Nutritional science has made such advances, we really have the tools at our disposal to almost wipe out these cancers. But the problem is nobody's taking advantage of the science. People are ignoring it, denying it, avoiding it. They're not interested in it. But in any case, my mission is to make sure that this information is widely known enough so people could have an opportunity to choose and say, yes, I want that. I want to add 20 years to my life expectancy. I want not to have a heart attack or a stroke. I don't want to get demented when I get older. I don't want to have breast cancer or prostate cancer. I can choose not to. And if you make that choice, I can outline what you would need to do to put those odds in your favor. What you would need to eat, how you would need to live to prevent those things from occurring. And that's where the advancements in science has happened, where we can actually put together a portfolio of foods in a person's diet and teach them how to eat to afford them this opportunity that's available today to dramatically have a better life without medical care, tragedies, and premature death, and all the suffering that's present that almost all Americans and people in the modern world have to deal with.